Hey, it's Heath Mulliken from The Gathering in Orlando, Florida. I'm here with Dr. Matthew Sleeth, the author of 24-6, which is just such a powerful book on Sabbath rest and Sabbath habits. Dr. Sleeth, how did the idea for the book come about? And did you think it would have as wide an impact? It's really impacted our entire denomination. But where did the heart for this book come from?
It really came out of my own personal experience. When I became a Christian 12 years ago, I read through the Bible on my own. I didn't have anybody to help. And I thought you were supposed to keep the Ten Commandments.
Right.
And so our family started keeping a Sabbath.
Wow.
And I just saw what that did for my children and my family and for me, for my faith. And when you discover something great and it happens to sync up with what's in Scripture, you want to share it. And
wow.
So that's really where 24-6 came from.
So if you don't mind me, how old were you when you became a Christian?
I think I was 46.
Wow. So for so many people like me who've grown up in the church, we grow up either not keeping the Sabbath at all or not keeping it correctly. What was it like at a mature age in life to start your Christian walk out on the right foot as far as the Sabbath is concerned?
Well, I didn't know I was starting on the right foot, but in retrospect, I really do. And of course, we see a world now where more and more people are complaining about having less and less time. And it doesn't matter how much money you have. The Economist had an article last issue, and they called it time poverty, that it's something everyone in society is experiencing. And I think that's probably why the book has had some resonance with a broader church, more than I even perhaps thought it was going to have.
Right. And the thing I love about your book is it's not just saying, hey, take a day off, but it has so many practical things to have an intentional Sabbath, but also a Sabbath that impacts your family. Share briefly, you talked about your family starting some Sabbath habits. What when you became a Christian and your family is making these changes, what did your Sabbath look like?
Well, even before we get to Sabbath, it was preparing for it.
Right.
So Hebrew slaves in the desert, they were picking up twice as much manna the day before.
Right.
And so you have to get your life organized.
Wow.
My children had to get their homework done. Things, shopping had to be ready. And that helped them learn the way of organizing their life and time.
Wow.
Then Sunday, which is when we celebrate our Sabbath, was a day of church and communion and fellowship. And going home and having a meal and naps and that sort of thing. We've been running this experiment for a dozen years. My children kept it all through high school, college, my son medical school, and now in residency.
Yeah.
And so I know that it works in the most demanding situations. And if you were to ask them now, they would say the reason for our success is that we had something one day a week nobody else had. We had a day where it wasn't what we were doing. We could just be a human being.
Wow. Thank you, Dr. Sleeth, not only for talking with us today, but for the book. You can pick it up lots of places online, Amazon, WPH online. I highly recommend it. It is a book every person needs to read, but if you're a pastor, layperson watching this, it's a wonder. So many churches have done sermon series on your book. And this is Heath Mulliken, and we'll talk to you soon.